Ohio.
It all began on Southfield. My dad dropped jewels, picked them up as I got old. My mom worked hard every week besides singing me to sleep. She cooked food for us to eat when she got home. Born in Columbus. You can assume they on the block. It ain't easy for some of us, opportunity don't knock. Even if it's just one of us, where I'm from, I mean a lot. I'm waiting so long for it to pop. Music of the mind like Stevie when you need me. Spiritual tones will never leave me. Golden, time frozen, who the chosen? Infinite style, the posing. Papa ain't raised me like that. What you put out, come right back, yeah. And if it's meant to be, and it's like that. The law of energy can't fight that, nah.
By the sign, I'm back for the first time. Already gone before you know it. It's me again, on your mind. It's me again.
Snowflakes on them piano keys. White girl snorting a portrait of Keanu Reeves. And these are the melodies the piano plays. And this the type of motivation rebels need. My luck down, bring it up at a level speed.
Fab is the best rapper I know. Hands down, like the best rap. He's a rapper's rapper. And every time I hear him, like, every time I hear him, it just makes me want to rap better. Fab is the best rapper I know personally.
Margiela, the bait camo, and the foam's Margiela.
He's probably the best rapper. He's the best rapper that I know, personally. The only other person who has ever made me feel like how Fab makes me feel when he raps is Tupac. That's how I always describe Fab, is like Tupac.
Redbone with a brother who be crippin'. I would give him guidance, but that isn't my position. And plus, if I tried, I'm not sure that he would listen.
I had to bring niggas over on Smith Road real quick. This
camera up there. That's like, why you don't see niggas out here no more.
No more at all, man. It's just been, I feel like this definitely represents a lot of the passion of my music. So people can always tell like who I'm spitting for. Like I can never just make candy music, you know what I mean? Or ordinary popping bottles. Like that's never what I saw. Like we saw a couple dudes with money. Like they was more so hustlers and a couple teachers that stayed back further in the good area, you know what I mean? They was good role models for us at the time, but this was more so what we saw every day. It's never been this quiet out here. I used to come over here all the time though, because my grandma and grandfather would stay here. And I would always come over here and mess with my grandma and grandpa. But I stayed out north in Cassidy. And Agnew Green, me and my mom did. And my mom was working and going to school nonstop. So like this was kind of like, she would kind of let me come up with my grandma's. I used to have a crazy basketball court. We used to play full court. Like Rick could tell you, I had a court. My grandpa put some cement down here. I had a court here. We'd play full court. Like we was Iverson in the gang. Like this was just some for real life shit, man. Man. I remember I broke this garage door and I came home. Like my mom told me, don't play basketball in the backyard. I played anyway. I had a tournament over here, like 30, 40 people. Broke the garage door. I went to school. She said she acted like it wasn't nothing wrong, like she wasn't mad at me. I went to school, came back, both my courts was gone. I ain't had no bike. She gave my courts to a church, my uncle's church, my Uncle Robert Shaw's church. She gave my courts to a church, and it was kind of the end of that. That's when we started taking our show on the road and started walking up to Southmore, different people's neighborhoods.
It's like reality dropped in, the feeling forgotten. When just last year you were popping, and such drop such and such, and they figure they got it locked in, but you don't make music to top them.
It used to be like a court. You can see it was a broken court. It just everybody. It was a summertime day. Everybody outside. So like the whole project is outside. Like everybody. You can just walk through a hoop, or just walk through and chill. But you really couldn't just walk through and chill unless somebody knew you like that. Like, yeah. Like it was kind of like that for a minute. Like on the real, like niggas had to get to know me.
We had a squad though for basketball too. We had a good team. Like, we'll always beat people. We used to hoop in Southmore, that's where it really went down. Where a lot of the rapping would go down too, because there'd be so many people waiting for next, and everybody thought, we thought we was like Wu-Tang. Everybody thought they had their rap group. We was a Rockefeller. My rap name might have been Shot a Kiss back in the day or something, like some just wild shit. Like, so we were freestyle on the side, and Like, as we got older, you'll start to see, like, who was getting nicer, like, who was really supposed to be freestyling, and who was just doing it because it was fun.
Lisa, we gon' shine. Lisa, we gon' shine. That's real shit. These niggas, I'm with, I kill with.
I had rapped, like, growing up, always. And I had just decided, like, yo, I knew Don and Ralph. I went to high school with him, and they introduced me to Lee. And I'm like, I had already been rapping by then. And I was like, people was like, yo, you really kind of good at this. And I had always took it like, yo, like, I just rap, just to rap. Like, because I always rap. Like, you know what I mean? It's just cool. Like, I'm not trying to, like, I always played it. Because one of my homies would try to get me to rap with him. Like, he had a group or something he wanted me to be in. And I was like, nah, I'm cool, bro. Like, you know what I mean? Like, he had me meet his manager and stuff. And, like, I rapped his manager. Like, oh, bro, like, she's crazy. Fuck with us. And I'm like, I'm cool, bro. Like, I'm not trying to be, like, you know what I mean? And then just one day, like, I don't know, something just switched. Like, I guess enough people just telling me, like, yo, bro, like. And then I used to battle people, too. And once I started, like, not losing, I started kind of realizing, like, yo, like, this is easy. Some things I would say, people would be like, what? And I'd be like,
how many of us strive to be great? How many of us fall victim to hate? How many of us fall victim to...
The first guy that ever had me like, oh my God, like, I thought I was the best in the world till I heard, like, I thought I was the best in the world. I had heard everybody, bro, like, everybody in the city, I thought I was the best in the world. I heard, I was out, I was like 17 years old. And I was doing this show with my cousin, and it was at Lounge 62 or 60 something, out north, I think that is. I'm not sure. And the Catalyst was there. And it was this circle of rappers, and we were all rapping, and I was just going, and dude to step up, and I just go. And the Catalyst was like, yo, this dude is hungry. Like, don't fuck with this dude is hungry. And I'm like, yo, that's what's up. Yeah, I'm that nigga. Then later on that night, it was his time, like, he had a set, and he rocked, and I'm like, he did, like, he went over that Mobb Deep, Shooklands.
Yeah.
Man, I was like, yo, I was like 17, though. And at the time, I'm like, yo, I never had heard of him or anything, and he was, like, talking to me and my cousin, and ever since then, like, it's been love, but I heard him, and I'm like, yo. But when I heard him, and he gave me my piece, I'm like, yo, okay.
Don showed me this video of him rapping, of Fab rapping. And I was like, fam, like, he can go, like, you know, like, but I still didn't really think nothing of it. I was like, you know, he raps, you know, he's a rapper, yeah, and, but he was so cool with Don that, you know, he started to come around, like, Fab started to hang out and be around more, and then the more I heard him rap, I was like, man, like, this dude is crazy.
Miss son of the summer, that's why I spit the hottest shit. Only talk money, never religion and politics. Only talk money, never religion and politics. Green bills, dollar signs, and commas is common sense. So am I changing right before you mud suckers? Pay no attention to haters, ignore you blood suckers. Cause when you doing you, the blogs explore you mud suckers. And all the girls that dissed us, now they wanna love us. How ironic, they say I'm the man, my flow bionic. They tap into what I'm spitting, they instant fans of my logic. Women wear milk and serve tax, man, this shit symbolic. To women issue apologies that they took a lot of me. My verses are monogamy. They say that life's a pretty picture. Well, I should just spit it and do photography. I know I'm young, but I promise I'll be here forever. Smoking in Don's whip, engine loud, seats leather.
But the art show was kind of like, art show was funny because, like, if you talk to Lee or anybody or, like, Don or Ralph about it at the time, like, I was mad, like, antsy, like. Like, I was all about the team, like, you know what I mean? Like, all right, I'm not ready. I got sit and wait my turn. Like, let me get songs ready to drop. But, bro, I was ready to go. Like, it was to the point, like, I know at a time I got on Lee's nerves. Like, I know it was a time we went to Rashad, and every beat Rashad put on, I just went, like, to every beat. Like, put me on every song, Lee. Like, let's go. Like, you feel me? I was just hurt. I just wanted to go. Like, the art show was me, but that was, like, all the years up before me dropping that in the making. Like, so that was so many stories to tell. That was easy. The Resurgence was from 2010, Bottled Emotion from 2010
to 2013, to February 26, 2013. You know what I mean? That's a lot of, to bottle that emotion, I just wanted to capture that time period, poor get poor, the rich get richer. Bigger picture, they just trying Rodney King of a nigga. Many cry, many die if you even may pour liquor. I read scriptures, drink liquor. Demons dance on my liver, so confused. They dance too long, so now it's bruised. Rather that than my mind, little homie, don't be confused. As the kings come, shout, applaud. Rebels dance on the God. It's me a lot. The South Side of Columbus is a unique place. It can do two things for you. It can motivate you and inspire you and make you want more, seeing what you see every day. Or it can physically drain the life out of you and make you a zombie by the age of 27 because of what you see every day. Like, it's like a cycle. Like, everybody that you went to school with grows up and does the same thing that their brother did, and then their kids do it, and it keeps going. So everybody, it's a big family because everybody knows everybody because nobody got out. Nobody made it. Like, you know what I mean? Nobody was able to get out. So, like, I see positive things coming. Like, I just feel like, as long as I stay hungry and inspired to get better and do better, better it'll come.
First for me is suicide, and suicide is seeming suitable. Hope you got a black tux fitted for your funeral. Head shy, body shy, murder what I do to you. But if you're flowing godly, I don't want nothing to do with you. Ill, wreck, ill, and you looking real unusual. You're acting real unusual.